If you have my winter window hanging, which is this nice snowflake on a colorful background, then here are a couple little tips to help you make that pattern more successfully. Hi, welcome to Epida Studio. My name is Elizabeth, and I help you make beautiful things with quilting, pojagi, and embroidery. If you have my winter window hanging, which is this 24-inch snowflake window hanging, then here's a few tips that will help you be more successful in the construction of this. The first tip that I'm going to show you has to do with this strip set that we make right at the very beginning. There are 5 pieces of fabric, and lay them out in the order that it says in the pattern. Normally, when we join things with the modern pojagi seam, it doesn't matter which order we join them in. But for this section, there is a little trick that will help it look more consistent when it's not hanging in the window. If you miss putting your pieces together this way, it won't matter when your piece is hanging in the window. The only time that this will look different is when you're working on it or if it's on a table or in an unlit area. But when it's hanging in a window with sunlight, then this won't even be noticeable. So to join these pieces, the first thing you're going to do is join the 2 edge pieces in pairs. That's the wider background and one of the snowflake fabrics. And it doesn't matter how we join these. So just join those two. So these 2 pieces have been joined with a pojagi seam, and you can check out the tutorial if you want to know how to do the seam. All the seams in this project are done with this same seam technique. And you can see when I fold it over that the seam allowances are different than in regular quilting. So on this side, the snowflake fabric, the white fabric, goes over the background fabric, and on this side, the background fabric goes over the snowflake fabric. And that seam is going to be what gives it the stained glass effect hanging in the window. But when we're going to join this piece into the middle, you're going to want to have one side where the snowflake fabric goes over both fabrics, and the other side where the snowflake fabric is under both fabrics. So on this piece, on this side, the background fabric is coming over the snowflake. So when I join this background fabric, I'm going to want to join it so it's going over the snowflake fabric. And then on this side, I want to have the snowflake fabric on top. So I will join it like this so that the snowflake fabric is on top. Now that description might not make any sense to you until you start sewing and seeing how things go together. But here's the sample all finished. So you can see on this side, the snowflake fabric looks wider, and on this one, it looks narrower. But when we fold it, so you can see the other side, you can see on the other side, this snowflake fabric is wider and this one is narrower. And so that will just help it look consistent when it is not hanging in a window. As I said before, if you don't do them this way, it's still going to be fine. It's still going to be a great snowflake. This is just a little tip to help it look even as you're working on it. The next tip that I'm going to share is another tip about these seams. If you've done any of my patterns before, if you've been in a workshop or taken an online class, you've probably heard me say, don't worry about getting all your seams in the same direction. You'll see when you begin stitching that one side of the seam has 2 rows of stitching and the other side of the seam has only 1 row of stitching. A lot of people get really bothered by that and they want them all to be on the same side, the same orientation. For this snowflake pattern, that is going to be very difficult to do that. So I recommend don't even try. It doesn't matter when it's hanging in a window, you're not going to know. If you're determined to do that, then good luck. But this is a really complex pattern for that kind of thing. And that leads me right into my third tip, which is when you're joining pieces, you might get pieces and you're thinking, oh no, I put it together the wrong way. It's not going to go. In this pattern, there are pieces that you'll join and then you'll have to turn them over. So remember, the pieces are reversible. So when you're trying to lay things out and you can't get it the right way, remember to turn it over, because that quite likely could be the correct orientation. I hope that these tips help you and that will give you the confidence to go ahead with this beautiful pattern. If you really have trouble with just a written pattern and you feel like you need more personal help, then you can check out my online course, which has full video instructions and I explain things more in depth, or you can sign up for a live workshop. These are fun. We do live workshops. I teach in person or I teach on Zoom. So you can join with people from around the world and get immediate help and feedback with any issues that you're having. For information about this pattern or any other window hanging patterns, check out epidastudio.com.